is Sarisha Shaiba. I'm the lab manager for the Functional Genomics Laboratory, and I'm going to give you a tour of our lab today. To start with, we have behind me here our robot. And so basically, this robot, it's sort of a room that's enclosed. It contains several different instrumentations that our automation team uses with us. So we have many different stackers and instrumentation which allow our automation team to take plates and reorganize them into smaller plates or cherry pick out specific SIs that we need. There is plate stackers, there's a washing station, and a robotic arm that kind of moves everything around for us. On the other side, we have plate readers that are also incorporated into this instrumentation. Here we have two high content imagers. One is the Image Express confocal, and the other one next to it is our Phoenix Opera. Both of these are high content imagers that we use for image-based assays. They are also part of our robotic system, and so they have stackers and a robotic arm, which allows us to image up to 25 to 30 plates kind of one single round, which in a high throughput setting is really useful for us. And as you can see, the arm for the Image Express is right next to it over there, and the arm for the Phoenix is on this side. And you can see the stackers that can hold up, like I said, 25 to 30 plates at a time. And the instrumentation will allow us to analyze data that we get from this high content imagers. Here we have our biofill wellmate. Basically, this is a liquid dispenser, liquid handled dispenser. And what it does is we can stack up the plates here, and we have our liquid reagent that we want to output into the plates. So the liquid handler will take the plate and dispense 20 microliters into each well. And once it's done, it'll put it back into this output stacker, and it'll continue doing it until all the plates are done. The reason we use this is we use it for our cell dispensing and lipid dispensing. This helps us be in a very automated and high throughput fashion. And in one setting, we can do about 30 plates, which allows us to do a large quantity of plates at the same time. This is our Ferristar FX instrument, and this is our plate reader. Basically, with this instrument, once our experiment is done, after 96 hours or something, 2 hours, depending on the length of the assay, we use this plate reader to plate read out such as luminescence, absorbance, fluorescence, and alkalisa, GFP. A lot of different sorts of readouts are can be used using this machine. It allows us to analyze the data and kind of see where we are with it. So this is our tissue culture room where we do cell culture. We have four tissue culture hoods, which is this one. And we have several different incubators to house all the different types of cell culturing that we do in this room. It's a standard tissue culture BSL 2 lab. And we do everything from primary cells to mammalian, suspension and adherent cells, all the different types you can think of. This is the wet lab. Here we have space, lab space for liquid dispensers as well as washers, which allow us to, the plate washers allow us to wash the plates and stuff we do for doing image-based analysis. And then we have bacterial station where we do bacterial work for cloning and subcloning, PCR area, where we do quantitative PCR. We have Sony cell sorter to sort cells based on color and size, an echo, which is an acoustic dispenser, a liquid dispenser. Basically, it'll use sound to bounce off to dispense volumes. And lastly, we have an iBright, which is automated Western blotting system. And that covers our wet lab space.